for a month after that. And then they're going to tell us
the people in the camp who were injured, and you know, they needed to keep. This was the only one that didn't fall sick because of the exercises that he showed them. Their immunity was really good. And Joseph Pilates himself was a boxer, he was a gymnast, he was a heavyweight lifter, he used to do competitions, he used to do yoga. His mother was a naturopath, she was kind of a naturopath. His father was, and his brother were both professional boxers, so he took a little bit of every science and created Pilates. That's why people say, oh, Pilates is so much like yoga, it's, you know, a lot like gymnastics. Because Joseph Pilates was all these things, and then he created this system where he embraced everything together, but we work from the core. And that's why when sports people, you know, always advise Pilates, because it helps them perform their sports better. Stand at the edge of your mat. Okay? Hands by your side. And just press into the balls of one foot without letting your weight shift. So why don't you guys face the mirror so you can see and come to the back of your mat. Right? So you can see what we're doing. Stand to your foot, and at the same time make sure your knees, I want you to lift and press it down, and lift and press it down, and lift. So you'll see what is happening, just to give you a little, because we never do this, you're so tentative about pressing into the balls of your feet. And why? Because the articulation of the foot never happens. When do we think of working our feet? And which is the part that works the most in our body? Our foot, right? Of the foot. And that is really important. And you realize if you do this, when you're sprinting, this is your stance, right? So, exactly. So that articulation of the foot is very, very important. Okay, it might seem bold. Don't feel shy. Press into that foot. Press. And down, and press, you're still not doing it, and down, and press, three, and down, and press, lift that heel off, and down, and press, four, and down, last one, press, and down. This time you're going to press and lift it to go to the toes, and then press back to the ball, kick, and up, and kick, and up, and plie. Don't push your butt back, and up. Imagine the wall, you're sliding your shoulders down the wall. Your knees will go ahead of the toes, because that's what.
So today we're having an informal session from the panel.
Nice to meet you.
And having the partner.
I just show up, I try and show up every day. That's my only goal with exercise.
So for me, definitely, all three of them here are icons. Me, Gul and Yasmin have been meeting for a long time, so I'm glad that, you know, this event has happened where they both come together to launch what is an important landmark for body image. So what I'd like to do is ask those influencers who have health groups experienced Pilates. Rehan was telling us about
waiting that one day I'm going to start Pilates, because I'm very experimental with my exercise.
Yes.
And that's the one
and the last time we met, you told me that I want to try
it's been on my bucket list to try, because I think it's really important to keep doing different things when it comes to fitness.
Correct.
And that's been on my bucket list, so yay, finally it's here.
And it's close to home for
yes.
us. So
yes,
yeah,
I'm going to
go.
But
like
all three of
us.
I'm not best for stretching.
Oh, I'm going to
Power of
Tower. So it's like two machines combined into one for playing. places like Mumbai where space is very expensive and you have to like really, you know, and I think they built it for us, not knowing that it would be for us, but also for people who don't have, like a lot of people abroad keep this in their house. So it's like getting to, yeah, you can literally lift, I mean, you have to move all of this, but if you see on the other end, there are wheels,
so it stands up
and you can lift, literally put this machine, I got it right. Yeah, sorry, not like that, but without that, it actually stands on that footrest.
And what happens to that?
No, that's on, that collapses.
Okay.
So what happens is,
we have these little knobs here
that I had, was in a building next door, and I spent a lot of money doing out the studio, and I had this machine, and the building put a case on me. I think they were trying to make sure nobody stabbed anybody.
Maybe
we
could go for one ribbon each or something.
No, I think
Yasmin can go for it.
I have to say that I'm really excited that we're in Andheri. We've already been in Bandra and South Mumbai, and you know, people in Andheri, every time we post pictures or videos, I'm putting some in, you know, fitness stuff, they're constantly asking me, when are you coming to Andheri? So yeah, it's great to be here. And now we'll have Gul coming, because the last time I met her was about 2 years ago.
Yes, yes.
And she was like, you don't have anything in Andheri.
I know, yeah, I'm really excited. Pilates has been on my list for a very long time, because I keep experimenting with various forms of fitness, just to mix things up a little. And so the one thing that has sort of not happened yet for me is Pilates, and I'm very thrilled about it being here, Yasmin. I'm going to probably be one of the early people who walk in.
And we're very excited to train you, because you're such a fitness icon.
So I hope I don't want to fall flat on my face and figure that I can't do anything, because that'll be quite
nobody
tragic.
Nobody from the age of 10 to 100 falls flat on their face with Pilates.
Because the springs are safe, and yeah. There are these little like stirrup looking things that prevent them from... So I keep watching with interest all the videos you post. And I keep wondering that this doesn't look so tough, but I'm sure it is.
It is.
So yes, I'm very keen to try it out.
I'm first of all here to support Yasmin. I think she's one of the best Pilates instructors out there. Another thing is that, like I mentioned, guys, they typically want to head into the gym and lift weights. And then after a while, that tends to become monotonous. Personally, I would love to incorporate something like this into my schedule. Yes, I'd continue working out in the gym. But for my sport primarily, for golf and for swimmers out there, and other sportsmen, I think flexibility is key. Balance on both sides of the body with strength is key. And from everything I'm hearing about the benefits of Pilates, I think it would take care of all of the above. So I'm excited to be here, and of course wish Yasmin
Thank
the very
you.
Best.
So what we also do with sportsmen who don't have the time to come to our studios is I teach them what I did with the bloggers today. Is I teach them like a 20-minute workout, and which they can do anywhere. And normally I tell them, you know, do it before you go into the gym or you do a game or whatever, and do it at least 3 to 4 times a week to see the difference in your game, because all international sportsmen do Pilates. In fact, right now I have a girl who represents India in badminton internationally. And of course she works from Hyderabad, and you know that training is there, and she's in Bombay for 3 days, coming down to the studio, and we're teaching her a routine that she can do when she goes back, because she says, I weight train and my, you know, my trainers make me do everything. They do flex, but nobody teaches them Pilates. And so for 3 days, we're only training, and that is just 1 hour a day she's coming. And we're only teaching her this routine that she can take back with her. And what I do then is I make little videos for them to show them the exercise, because you don't always remember,
sure,
you know, the exact details of how you do that. So we make these little videos, put it on a pen drive or send it to them, you know, on email or whatever.
My fitness mantra is essentially consistency, because I think if you
if you need sustained fitness levels to be maintained, it's only going to happen through consistency. A lot of people favor intensity, but I think what really eventually the buck stops with consistency. You've got to do it every day, day after day. Not to say you shouldn't take rest days, but I prefer doing something every day. My rest day is also usually a light day because I don't want the routine to break. So on my seventh day, I'll probably just take a walk, make some calls while I'm walking. But I get into my fitness clothes just to make sure that I remain regular. Because with the kind of lives we all lead, things are a bit hectic and it's so easy to fall off the bandwagon. We all have a list of excuses we can make. Like literally, I can write a book on the excuses that I can make for not exercising. So I just believe showing up is the most important thing. What you pursue, whether it's whether it's Pilates or mixed martial arts or HIIT or conventional gym and you know sport, I think it's really important to just make sure you tick that box every single day, 35, 40 minutes of elevated heart rate every day for the rest of your life.
Okay. Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations.